It's FOMO time. Hey everybody, it's me, SpongyNightmare64, and welcome to the camera me trying to get the camera in the right place at the right time. Welcome back to Minecraft, and we're going to be playing my zombie game once again, because Terrence is not with me, because he just doesn't want to play. I've tried already talking to him, he just won't play. Which is a nightmare, so I'm going to just be here alone, I'm afraid, for this episode, but don't worry, Terrence will be back, I hope, next time. Yeah, I got everything ready, so that's it. I got night vision on, so you can see better. By the way, because this game is dark. Okay, I have played this before actually, as kind of a special. So I guess you kind of get already a sneak peek of it. Yeah, this is actually my favorite, probably one of my favorite games in the entire Fun World, probably because it's just a resemblance of a really good zombie map. I'm getting so much XP. Stone sword. Nothing good. So that's the door. I don't see any googlies just yet. I mean, yeah. There's a lot of zombies say, ow! Wait, am I not in hard mode? I guess this explains why am I in hard mode, I'm just not realizing it. So many zombies! Get back, bitches! Who closed the door? No, I'm dead! I'm legit dead! That went well. I don't know, why is the game darker? Okay, what if the other one? Oh, okay, we're not in hard mode. Never mind. Good thing now we are in hard mode, official hard mode. Which is hard. Hopefully we'll die more. This is a good thing. Back, zombies, back! What am I doing here? I should use my sword more. I'll catch you all. Come here, zombie. I'll rick your butt. Yeah. Ow. Get wrecked. Sharpness. Yes. 12 rod flesh for iron axe. Enchanted golden shovel. Let's just get this one because this one is the best thing in the game. Yeah, because this has looting on it. I'll dig their graves. It only does one damage though, because this is meant to be like a submachine gun. Ow, there. Thank you. And my night vision's about to run out, so let's just drink up another one. Yeah, I only got the 3 minutes once, because it doesn't really matter. Dig your grave, you stupid zombie. Let's eat some food. Ah, so much health. Regenerate my health. There's a creeper right there. I never get it. Ah! You kind of, you almost scared me there, zombie. Okay. Yeah, zombie, get wrecked. Get wrecked, zombie. Let me eat some of this. Mmm. Delicious. I remember when I first made this game, I actually had doors, and zombies would break down the doors to get to you. I removed that eventually and just made it so zombies will always be able to get you. I mean, even then, there are still some doors, as you can see. They're just not as much. Chanted wooden shovel, we don't need that, and it's not entirely worth it. I'll kill you all with my shovel. A powerful shovel. You don't really need to buy a bow. They're just there if you want them, but they're not really necessary because you can just... You can survive without bows, you see. Bows are not necessary to survive. What is necessary is you. I hope. Anyway. Okay, let's jump here, make sure we have no googlies following me. There are a lot of games that are really fun worlds. So... Okay, we're running out of time on this, but I'm questioning whether I should even use the potion or not, because I might die. I think I saw a creeper there. So much gunpowder. Let's regenerate my health. Creepers were made from a... Have you ever heard about how creepers were made? They were made from like when Notch accidentally... Notch did a mistake. He accidentally made creepers because he extended the Y axis instead of the Z axis. He got them, you know, he got them muddled up, and so the creepers were born. So creepers were actually made from a coding error. The more you know. I think, then again, I think that's kind of obvious. I think everybody knows that by now, but like, you know, it's funny how to think that that the creeper was kind of made like that. That's the origins of the creeper now. And it's turned out to probably be the most terrifying thing in this game. Because these guys aren't scary. Die, zombie, die! You can't defeat me, zombie. I am strong. Strong, I tell you. Strong. Very, very strong. Okay, so... Fuck. Five Nights at Freddy's, it's a place you wanna be, it's so scary, it's a place you wanna be at Five Nights at Freddy's. We are waiting here, it's a place you wanna be, it's okay. It's Nights at Freddy's. I don't know why I'm singing that song, to be honest. Anyway, stuck in my head. I don't know where all the goodies are gone. If this wasn't a computer version, I would have like command blocks, I guess, or like spawners that spawn the zombies. You know, I would work my way around it. There would be a way to get the zombies. This place to always have zombies or something. I don't know. One more flash. Okay, let me drink this. Thank goodness for the fact that night vision potions exist. Wee. Ow. That was stupid. 1997, a place you wanna be, it's a Five Nights at Freddy's. I got a shovel, I'm not afraid to use it. It does a lot of damage. It's very, very strong. Where is them? Where are the zombies? Zombies? They're always called the zombies? No? Don't get it? Zombies? Zombies? Get it? The zombies? Also in this one you can kind of, also in my zombie game you can kind of get into the zombie spawners if you do some precise jumping. But that's okay, because it means you can, because it kind of gives you a behind the scenes of how I made it, and it's not really interesting. Not really interesting what goes on back here. You can kind of get to the back of the spawners. Yeah, I got myself the bow. See, that's what I mean. You can get bows just from them. You don't need to buy a bow if the skins drop it. If you do need one, you can just buy it for like 10. Just keep it real. Yeah, this world is just a fun world. You know, the world is just a fun world. You can do whatever you want. You don't need to obey any of the rules I put up. They're just there if you want. They're just there, really. They're there because I put them there. But like really, you don't need to worry about them. If I'm not around, you kind of can do anything yourself, really. You can make up your own rules, I guess. But like, if you want to keep things original, then go ahead, follow my rules. Then again, I'm the only one who owns this world, so really, yeah. Would anybody actually ever want this world? That's my real question. I mean, truly, it's just a fun world. So, you know, I mean, I guess there are certain YouTubers and certain players who would actually find endless amount of joy from these things, probably. Because there really is a lot of things to do. Some things are more hard than others. Oh my god, a zombie with a weapon. So I can get that weapon from him, because you can get it if you have looting. Oh, No, he didn't drop it, dang it. Okay, I need a heal up. Okay, let's regenerate health. Get a health regen up. I think I'm kind of figuring out how the health regen works now, by the way. When you're at full health, you regenerate health. You regenerate like 1 to 4 hearts of health. In this version, anyway. And then you'll just go up by a random, and then there's like a random chance, and you'll repeatedly gain one point of health, but there's a random chance that you will lose one point of hunger when you regenerate that 1 point of health. So you only gain 2 hearts, but it's going up by now, and I'm not sure what the percentage chance is. I think it's like probably like 50%. Maybe it's like 25%, but after you lose your first hunger, it will always be 100%. But that first point of hunger can be would be dependent, I guess. I don't know. I'm thinking into like how the regeneration works in this game, you see, because that could be useful in strategies. It's useful in various strategies, I guess, to know how you get. You can use the game mechanics as a strategy. That's how speedrunners work. It's also how you can do certain glitches and certain other things. The more you understand it, the more it works, I guess. The more ways you can get the game to do one thing, the more ways you can manipulate it, I guess. So there's. Although then again, some glitches, like in Pokemon Yellow, are just entirely random. Like with Misano, the thing is with Misano on Pokemon Yellow, when you encounter him, there's a 15% chance that he, there's an 85% chance that he basically just crashed the game. Because of how the game works, but that doesn't mean he always crashes the game. So therefore he will, and when he doesn't crash the game, that's where you get it right. Sometimes he crashes the game, but he does. He also has a slight chance of crashing the game if you run from him, and a chance. He also has. The chance of him crashing the game is slightly decreased once you've encountered him once, though. So really, you don't need to worry as much. Any other time, it's just the first time, really. Even still, it takes me forever to encounter him any other time. I don't know why I'm talking about Pokemon Yellow when I'm in a zombie game. The original zombie games are a lot difficult then. On the actual Black Ops and stuff, because any of the other Call of Duty games that really have zombies in it, you only can get hit twice by the zombies, really. You get hit once, you're okay, but like if you get hit again, you're screwed. And there are, of course, then again, there are different types of zombies, so that means that the different types of zombies do different amounts of damages. Getting hit once, though, is not the end. However, there's also the Juggernaut perk, which basically just makes it so you can get hit a few more times before you get downed. I just hear zombies fall. Where would a zombie fall from? I'm thinking to where a zombie would fall from because that seems odd. Zombies! Because there are various amount of places where zombies can get hurt for some reason. Whilst in Black Ops, zombies are pretty much invincible. Well, not really. All zombies are beatable. It's like on the Wii version. On the Wii version of Zombies, it's terrifying because like you got the freaking Wii remote to worry about. You have to worry about swinging that damn thing in the wrong place. The only way to counter that is by using a classical controller. Although the Wii version is difficult alone because you see movement on the Wii version is a little bit more difficult. Like moving around is kind of difficult because you have to wave the Wii remote to get. You have to kind of control the Wii remote most of the time. There's ways around. The ways around that is to use nunchuck. It's by using certain other methods to move. And I'm dead. Holy shit. Yeah. The Wii version of Black Ops Everyday is just terrible as well in graphics. It sucks. Seriously, the graphics suck on the Wii version. I don't know why. Then again, so did the DS version. I've never played the DS version though. How would I know what it looks like? I just know these things. Trust me, I'm Adrian. Spongy Nightmare 64. F off yourself, Justin. You don't watch Justin shouting them out. And lots wrong with Trist. He's kind of... You don't need to say F off, Tristan. My viewers can hear you. Call of Duty Black Ops inspired me to make this map, I guess. Then I gotta get Black Ops out. Although the Wii version, I can't. Although I did kind of model some of this after the Wii and some of this after the original version, because there on the Wii, the mystery box is like here instead of here where it should be. And there's actually a glitch or like a problem in the Wii version where if you stand here, there's a slight part where your character clips slightly into the floor, and whilst you're standing there, no zombies will for some reason go below you instead of straight to you, which is pretty cool. It's useful in multiplayer, but terrible when you're alone. But not entirely useful when you're alone. Oh crap. On the Wii version, most versions you can go back here basically, but on the Wii version you can't. So I have this replicate that because the zombies come from a hole here instead. It's also like on most versions you can go through here, but like on the Wii version you can't, so I have a block here so to replicate that. Another thing is on the Wii version you have an extra gun, which is like here, but I don't have it. To replicate that I have this instead. Which is basically where you get the gun from instead. Just in case you want it. I did more than some things around the Wii because why not? Because why not? So, although there are some problems, like this is not meant to be like this at all in any version of the game. The reason why I have it like this is because Minecraft. Because Minecraft doesn't have corners. Or because, I don't know, maybe it's because I modeled some part of this map from too big. Or something, I don't know. It's to go. The knife. Let's get a better knife. So we're gonna go here. Now you can get the bone axe, which is has sharpness 5. Which is basically the bowling knife. No! No! Why did I ask me if I'm loading? I'm recording, but that doesn't count as uploading. Slippery snakes. Mario, where are you? No, but I am recording though. Yeah. Well, I think I dragged this on for a little bit long enough, so I'm going to call it off here. So I'll see you guys next time.